In Romans chapter 12, well, the writer tells us how we should respond based on all the chapters he's already written, chapters 1 through 11. He says, therefore, now, this is what we should do. And listen, he says, present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God. And then he goes on to tell us what that looks like. Serve the Lord with your spiritual gifts, behave or have a lifestyle like a real believer. He says things like, don't repay evil with evil, feed those who are hungry, and the best you can, live peaceably with all men. And then he goes into chapter 13, and he tells us to respond civilly or to the government in a specific way, and not to, well, there's a warning about getting involved with people who cause conflict or bring about some kind of division in the body. And then he closes it out with this amazing passage, and I want you to listen to it. Here's what he says. He says, the night is far spent, the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness and let's put on the armor of light. Walk properly as in the day, not in revelry and drunkenness, but not in lewdness and lust, not in strife and envy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its lust. After all that has been written, all that's been said, chapters 1 through 11, about the Christ sacrifice, about justification, about the great salvation of Jesus Christ, he says, okay, present your body, live like a Christian, privately and in public, and put on the Lord Jesus Christ. In other words, live for him. Look at all that he's done for you.